Welcome to rygurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about capacity planning in Jira. When we talk about Jira advanced roadmap, capacity planning is a very important part of any project lifecycle. In capacity planning, we are managing the complete project and defining the actual capacity of our project. So we'll see here how to use Jira capacity planning for effective project management. So if you want to learn Jira from scratch, please watch my complete Jira playlist. I will also include the URL in description tab. And if you're visiting this channel first time, don't forget to like and subscribe the channel. When we will jump into the plans, here we have to select the project plan which we have created. And capacity planning is a functionality of premium account. Those who are having premium account or licensed version of Jira, they will be able to use this. Otherwise, others don't have the access in free plan. So here we have to select this sprint capacity planning, and you can see here there are different teams are available. So as of now, you can see these are the teams. So let me just save it. Now here we can see this is our capacity planning board where we will have these are the teams. So let me remove this. I will show you from beginning, and these are the external sprints. Now if you want to add the team, generally when we are adding the team, first we have to navigate into the team sections, and from here we can create a team or we can add the team. So let's say we want to add the teams, we'll add here from this options available. Or otherwise, if we want to create a new team, here we have to go here, click on create team. Let's say I want to create a team for DevOps activity. Then I'll define the name DevOps and select this options and click the add the person. So here I'm just selecting my name here and then adding the people inside this. Now our team is ready. We have four teams are available. Now to go to the plan, here we have to navigate into the plan, and from this we can add inside the team. When we are adding the team here, we can have the capacity, how many story pointers capacity we have. We can also customize it accordingly. In team settings, we can change it capacity points accordingly. Capacity planning here. So if we want to add the teams, generally for doing this type of activity, we have to do the customizations. We cannot directly utilize the capacity planning. Once we open the capacity planning, we have to do the customizations. Without that, we won't be able to see the complete structure. So let's say if we want to enable the team sections, simply we will select this and the teams options will be available. If you want to enable the sprint and story pointer, that also possible to added from here only. So here we have the story pointers. Now if I want to remove this, simply I will remove it from here, and we don't have that options are available. We can also add several other components from manage custom fields to showcase inside the teams. Now if we want to add the team, simply we'll select here. But generally when we are selecting this, first we have to update the team structure, otherwise we won't be able to see into the issue sources, or that will showcase into different options. So I'm selecting the issue sources as is, right? Because this is my project. I will also do it team setting issue source is right, and let me add another team from here. We have created DevOps team, so I'm adding here. So this is my fourth team. So if I will navigate into the sprint, we can see it here. The fourth team is showing, but at the time of adding the fourth team, we don't have any options because issue sources are not defined. So probably we'll go to the teams, and from here we have to define the issue sources so that we will see the issue sources available inside our capacity planning. Now jump into the sprint. Here you can see the project sprints are highlighted. So even we can see in today's monthly basis or quarterly basis according to our need. And once we select, we can see the sprints projections or start date and end date. Then second options I'm selecting, then surgeon is my third team and project team is the fourth one. Again surgeon. So you can see here all the data which is available here. So even we can see the total capacity of the teams on each and individual team, which we can modify it accordingly. If we want to enable fields like for save this, then we will have the complete structure. Every time whatever modifications we are doing, we have to update it. Otherwise, we won't be able to see complete detail. So at the time of adding the sprint, here we can define sprint now. And here we have the view settings options. If we don't be able to see these sprints, so whenever we are selecting this, first we have to either select sprint and team. So if we do not see the options or capacity planning contents are available, let's say I'm selecting none, so we won't be able to see the team structure. So if we want to see the capacity planning with the team, so either we have to filter out whether sprint or teams. So as of now I'm selecting teams and make sure this checkbox should be checked, otherwise we won't be able to see the detail. You can see this. So every time whenever we are selecting this structure, we have to see this should be checked. And here once we're selected, we can see the complete structure with the sprint planning, how many days we have. So this is a quarterly, we can also see on the monthly basis. And this is our dependency, how we are adding. In the sprint structure, let's say we have project is in backlog section, we have removed this. So let's add some of the items so that we'll have some data. Let's add in sprint 2. Let's add this as well. Now, these backlog items are added into the sprints. Let's go back to the plan again. And this time we can see these are the sprints are available. So this is how we can make our effective capacity planning, and we can see our detailed structure, how our team are utilized, and if anyone is underutilized, we can also correct it. Now if story points, now we have additional fields as story points. So here, let's say our this particular is added with the some story pointers and our capacity is exceeding. So let's say our capacity is having 30, then I am defining here 100. So that will become in red mark or red highlighted, so that it was showing the warning like we have capacity of just 30 story pointers, but we have allocated the work of 100 story pointers, which is might be in danger case. So this is how we can highlight the over exceeded expectations set to the any particular candidate. So that's all from the capacity frame. Let's recap. First, an important part in Jira sprint capacity planning is whenever we are selecting capacity planning, we have to do some customizations. Without that, we won't be able to finish it. First, customization will be required on grouping either by team or sprint. Second options, we have to add the teams as well. For addition of the teams, here we have to select the teams, and from there we can add the team as well as assign the issue sources. If we won't be able to assign the issue sources, we don't get any data within the board. Third point is adding the fields item from here. So these are the field items and assigning to each and every bucket and the team. Fourth is story pointer assignment, where if we have the story pointer allocated, that is well and good, so that we can see how the team is underutilized or overutilized. Then we have did some filter operations as far as, and we have seen different items in capacity planning in Jira. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.